it is. The women's singles up next, and a very welcome to return here. Centre court and centre stage for Scotland's number one and defending champion here in the women's singles, Kirsty Gilmour, in action against the unseeded Japanese Sayaka SATO for place in the final here tomorrow. She may be the rank outsider and a very long way from home here, SATO, but she has a chance here to step up to the plate, stake a claim, and perhaps go even one step further, one final hurdle to causing one of the biggest upsets here this week in the tournament.
And please welcome our opponent from Scotland, the number one seed, Kirsty Gilmour.
Well, just listen to the applause as she makes her way onto the court here for Glasgow's finest, Kirsty Gilmour, the number one seed here in the women's singles, and she's still here in continuation of the defence of her crown. 21 years of age she may be. She's gathering a vital experience in every single tournament, and so far this week she's been at her imperious best, to say the least. Well, once again, it is myself, Errol Creary, alongside Gail Emms in the commentary booth. And Gail, we've just witnessed the first match of the day, the men's doubles won by the number six seeds from Denmark, leading the English duo Matthew Nottingham and Harley Towler, Christensen and Dargaard. They played well, and let's hope for plenty more of that here in the women's singles.
I think the men's doubles has set us up nicely for the day ahead. I think the crowd have got a taste of world-class badminton that's on show here at the Scottish Open, and I think this singles is going to be a great game.
Well, world-class badminton at its best since the tournament opened up on Wednesday. And here we are, the penultimate day here in Glasgow. 236 players, 31 nations and four continents. And it's come down to this. These two fighting it out for the right to re-emerge once again on the court tomorrow, contesting here for the title. Well, there's our official, our chair umpire, Miss Garcia, in the chair for this one. Now, she's the red-hot favourite here, Gail, is Kirsty Gilmour. What does she need to do here, SATO, to upset the apple cart and place herself in the final?
Well, you say that Kirsty Gilmour is the red-hot favourite, but I'm not so sure she's going to be feeling like that. SATO is a fantastic player who's been out for a good year with a very, very bad ankle injury, and she's on her way to recovery. And SATO used to be in the top... I'm top 15 of the world. So Kirsty knows that she's got her work cut out for her. Yes, she is favourite on paper, but this Japanese girl, Japanese badminton, is incredibly strong. So Kirsty will feel the pressure here, and it's just whether she can stay relaxed, play her game, and just show some authority on that court.
Well, it was this time last year where Kirsty Gilmour really did show us what a fantastic badminton player she is, where she claimed the prize. She is currently world ranked 25, right-handed player, 21 years of age. Highest rank as a singles player, 25. In fact, that is 16, currently at 25. And here she is once again as the number one seed. She's here to defend her title, Commonwealth silver as well, Gail. For such a young player, fantastic CV already.
Yeah, she's a great player to watch as well. What I love about Kirsty is that she gives everything on that court, that she leaves nothing behind. And she wears her heart on her sleeve. She dives for shots. Sometimes I feel that she should have knee pads and elbow pads on, maybe a crash helmet sometimes, the way she plays her badminton. So she's a great role model for young girls to play badminton.
But here she is, the unseeded player, 23 years of age, from Sendai, Japan, 1.71 metres. And she is a left-handed player, currently enjoying a position of 43 in the ranking table. Was as high, in fact, as 14, and that was August of 2012. And who can forget in that very year, 2012, at the London Olympics, where, unfortunately for the Japanese player, she did end up in tears, having to pull out of her quarterfinal of a badly twisted ankle versus the number five seed from Denmark, Tina Bount, having a 15-11 advantage in the first game, Gail. She's enjoying a fantastic season. She may be unseeded, but so far she is yet to drop a game en route to the semi-final. Impressive stats.
Oh, she's doing
Ladies
really well, and she is on that.
Right.
She's on the road to recovery.
But
Kirsty, she's playing well. You know, Kirsty's had a bit of a tough game in the quarterfinal. But Sato, very easy route, and she had some good players. Petra Nedvedeva in the first round, very good.
Well, here we are, eyes down, ready to go. The second semi-final of the day here in Glasgow, the women's singles. Kirsty Gilmour, the defending champion, to serve first.
Well, there is a side drift. We've seen it in the men's doubles in the previous game where players, particularly on how our viewpoint is on our right-hand side, that players are leaving the shuttle, but it's actually drifting into the court. There may be a right-to-left drift.
Well, that is very well left. Excellent judgment. Start here made by Gilmour. Just to see her back here on the main court in Glasgow, defending her title, aiming to be the first Scottish women's singles winner since Susan Egelstraff in 2009, in fact.
Well, that's a fantastic shot from Kirsty Gilmour. That is a really, really hard shot to play. And she's back in that backhand corner. She takes on her forehand and she reverse slices that shuttle. So she cuts the shuttle down. It looks like she's going to play a straight shot. And she slices that shuttle, twists the racket, over-rotates her wrist. And it just cuts down. Complete disguise.
Arms to the floor there by the line judge.
One, three.
That's the first point on the board for the unseeded player. Well, last year was the first ever Grand Prix event in Scotland, in fact. Good to be back here again in Glasgow. And this year it has promised to be even better after the big success, of course, of this year's Commonwealth Games, where some of the best players in the world tasted the fantastic atmosphere in this very arena.
Beautifully judged drop shots. They're the perfect shots to hit. Just getting that net, brushing the top of the net, and it falls over.
There's so much disguise there from Gilmour.
I love how she apologised afterwards when she really didn't mean it either.
That's fantastic sportsmanship. She has such a good feel for the racket, Gail. Such a repertoire of skills in her locker already at such a young age, 21, remember.
Yep, in singles, you have to have all these shots. You have to be able to play any shot from anywhere on the court.
She's doing that already, mixing up her game here to great effect. Second time these two players have faced off on opposite sides of the net, in fact, in their careers. It is Gilmour who leads the head-to-head stakes, one match to nil, being last year in the London Grand Prix gold competition. 21-17, 21-10, that they expect another tight match again today, Gail.
Yeah, I think it is going to be another tough game. And I think, you know, it's all about Sato and her recovery. She was in the top 15 of the world. Whether she's playing like that again, she had such a horrible injury. Whoa, and I remember commentating on that match. So I was talking about her. We were talking about the game against Tina Baun at the London 2012 Olympics. And suddenly we saw Sato on the floor. And it was just heartbreaking to see an athlete in such a state. So for her, every match is a building block again. So hopefully where she was, she once was, because she was an incredible badminton player.
Well, so far this week, she has knocked out two seeded players. The number four seed from Germany, Karin Schnassner. Straight games in just 36 minutes, in fact. And Anna Thea Madsen, the number eight seed from Denmark, 21-14, and a very impressive display in the second game, 21-8 in just 27 minutes.
Service over, 5-6.
I was very fortunate in my career that I never had a serious injury, but how incredibly tough it would be mentally to know where you were and then having to go back and play all the smaller tournaments to get your fitness back up, your game back up to a level where it once was. It must be incredibly hard.
Well, it's good disguise again from Gilmour. Crowd certainly enjoying that last point. Masseria delight, that is their lady. She's gone ahead to get it. Now she's as close to home as ever she could wish to be here, Kirsty Gilmour. Her father, of course, the chairman of... Born and raised here in Glasgow, number one seed.
Serving the nets.
Service over, 6-7.
I like how she was mixing up her serves. She's been doing the high forehand serve to the back of the court, but she tried to mix it up with a low backhand short serve, which is more of a double serve.
Well, she's posing Gilmour a lot more problems now, right now, Sato. 7-all. More of a tighter affair. Difficult out there today for Gilmour, playing a left-handed player.
Yeah, it's incredible, isn't it? When suddenly a left-handed player goes onto the other side of the court, suddenly everything just goes a little bit topsy-turvy.
Oh! Right through the body there of the unseeded Japanese player. It's certainly... Well, it's a great effect there for Gilmour. Already so far this season, the 21-year-old from Glasgow has three titles to her name. Spanish Open Women's Singles Champion, again in the doubles. What a week that was. And the Capiro Swedish Masters Women's Singles Champion as well. Looking to go one better this week in Glasgow.
Loopy net shot from Kirsty Gilmour, but she got away with that shot. Sato did the right thing. She wanted to attack, but she hesitated. And that made her hit that net kill into the net.
Beautiful rally, what an end again. Put into the body a couple of times there. Sato again mixing things up beautifully to great effect.
Yeah, both girls using their power. So often singles, especially ladies singles, many people think of soft shots, drop shots and clears, but these girls have been attacking the shuttle really, really well, using the drives, making each other work every inch of that court. And Kirsty Gilmour just saw that gap in the forehand corner, the forehand rear corner of Sato, and she disguised her shot really well and just looped over her head.
Well, Gilmour once again back in the ascendancy here, clear by 3 points. Well, she started well and she's finished well. Has Kirsty Gilmour, the number one seed. 11 points to 7, the difference. Just asking a lot more questions now of a very stubborn opponent in Sato. Interesting to see if she can keep this up, Gilmour.
Well, Yvette Yunlo, her coach, is a former China international badminton player. Incredibly talented lady. She's a great coach as well. She's coached in the GB setup as well, but now she's based up in Scotland and loves working with Kirsty because Kirsty is such a feisty player, works really hard, and she gets Yvette's attitude to training that you have to work really hard at ladies singles. So she'll just be telling her to stick at it, get those gaps. Don't force the errors too much. But interesting, Sato, she's here all on her own. Has no coach here, so very lonely place for her right now. She might need a little bit of help there. She's 11-7 down, but unfortunately no coach with her.
Yes, exactly. She's here incognito, a long way from Japan.
Play.
Just needs to gather her thoughts here and try to make inroads into this deficit once again.
Great defensive play from Gilmour. Retrieval. Just kept getting that shuttle back. And she got her reward.
We're looking to achieve the win double here this afternoon is Kirsty Gilmour. We're back at some stage later on here in this very court in the women's doubles. At the number three seeds with a good friend and partner, Imogen Bankier, against the number one seeds from Bulgaria, in fact, Gabriella and Stephanie Stoeva.
She'll be very disappointed with that shot. It's a very simple drop shot there. Whether she hesitated, changed her mind at the last minute. A simple drop shot went in the net. Cheap point to give away. And another cheap point, and she knows it.
9-13.
Well, so far in this opening game, she's controlled her emotion very well, Kirsty Gilmour.
I think Sato was unlucky there. She worked the. She knew what she was going to do. She's pushing Gilmour into her forehand corner, but unfortunately for her, the shuttle went out.
Oh, just looking to drop that over the net. Again, disappointment there for Sato.
15-9.
As we said, girl, no coach here, just to draw some confidence on those words of wisdom, the encouragement, so she needs to do it all herself.
Singles is a very lonely place anyway. You haven't got a partner to talk to. And the fact that she's just here on her own and no coach or anything, even it's just a look of just reassurance. There's just no one there for her.
You know,
Should we go down and help her?
16,
go down and say it's okay.
Oh, well, on the surface of things, it's the complete opposite, really, for Kirsty Gilmour. David Gilmour, Craig Robertson, John Quinn, Yvette Lenoud, Diana Carrillo as well. She's got a real good team behind her. She utilises that as well. That is delicious, absolutely delicious from Kirsty Gilmour. You see her at her best there in that last rally.
There are not many girls who can do this with their backhand. Absolutely fantastic. She holds her racket up. She could do any shot she chooses at that position. She's to the shuttle early. She's got her racket up. And then your opponent will always be on the back foot.
That's good, Badminton.
in the summer.
Difficult to know which side she was going to go there. Gilmour made her move and she was completely wrong-footed in the end.
That's a left-handed swinging from outside around the shuttle. Very difficult to see where that shuttle is going to go. Well, that's the second drop shot Kirsty Gilmour's hit into the net 17. From that forehand corner.
Well, she's going to try and do that now. It's as good a time as any. 17-11. Yeah. Okay. Such a fantastic feel for the racket.
12,
such a joy to watch at times.
She really moves well, Sato. She's incredibly physical, great strength in her legs. It's her racket work that needs the most work. And so she's obviously got that physical confidence back. Her ankle, she's got no strapping on her ankle. So in that sense, that could be fine. It's just that the touch and the feel of a shuttle, how to, when you're in position and moving and the timing, that's just off sync a little bit, much more off sync than what we know that she could get to.
Well, that's just out, but she really is in a rich vein of form, is Sato. Runner up in her last two tournaments, in fact. Just out in the Victor Career Grand Prix. At the number 7 seed, a fellow Japanese, Nozomi Okuhara. 17-21, 13-21, as well as the Yonex USA International Challenge as the number 2 seed to another Japanese player, in fact, Kayori Imabeppu, the top seed, 19-21, 20-22.
There are incredible Japanese athletes at the moment, so she's up against a lot, and you can see why she's doing all these tournaments to try and get her ranking up. But she does seem to be losing out to her fellow, a colleague.
As I said, piece by piece, 19. Brick by brick, she's just getting back to where she was. When she was as high as 14 a couple of years ago, Gail, really would be good to see her in and around the world top 10 again.
Yeah, and I mean that in a completely, as a fellow athlete, well, I call myself a fellow athlete, I'm an ex-athlete. I still think of myself as an athlete. But you don't want that, you don't want someone to end their career on an injury. It's harsh, it's a harsh world anyway, let alone for that to happen. So, no, I do wish her all the best.
Both players coming into this very semi-final today. Both on a rich vein of form. Confidence aplenty. 21 victories each, just the 9 defeats. But of course it is Gilmour. 3 titles so far this year, and twice already so far this year. The Yonex Scottish National Women's Singles Champion, as well as doubles champion here as well. That's one game point saved. Good deal of bravery shown there from Sato.
It's sometimes easier to be behind in this position because you're more relaxed. And the nerves are with your opponent who's up, who needs to finish the game off, and that could be the hardest job to do.
There it is, taken. The second bite of the cherry there for Kirsty Gilmour, the number 1 seed. The job is halfway done here, perhaps, for Glasgow's finest. She takes that opening game in some style. And a lot to do here for the unseeded Sato if she is going to turn this around, Gail.
Yeah, she has got a tough job. It really is in Kirsty Gilmour's hands now. If she can go out like she did in that first game and get that great lead that she had, that is the key to Kirsty winning this match and to keep that concentration, because she was really far up. I'm not sure how many points up. It must have been at least 6 or 7 points up. And she let Sato back in the game for no reason whatsoever. So she has to keep her concentration. The minute you start taking your foot off the gas against a player of such high caliber as Sato, then you could get caught out. Now, Kirsty wants to do really well in the doubles as well. She's in the doubles later. She needs to conserve energy. So for me, I'd really want her to go into this second game and just win easily, because for her, that's how she's going to win. If she's going to improve as a singles player, she needs to learn how to do that. Rather than showing off a little bit, maybe, just trying the odd crazy shot, I don't want to see that. I want to see really good, solid badminton. And then it's up to Sato for the one to be try to do the crazy stuff, or, you know, a little bit, something a little bit different. And because she's in the relaxed position, she's got nothing to lose now. Whereas Kirsty has. And for her to be, she's a reigning champion, she's got the crowd with her. You know, I want to see a real solid professional performance in this second game.
Well, certainly from her perspective, point of view, as well as her coach,
second game,
former China international, that's exactly what they'll probably be touching upon. Interesting to see exactly what the mindset of Gilmour would be if Sato were to get off to a nice clean start here in game number two.
Too long.
But it's not the start that she would have wanted. Sato winning the net battle. Sometimes it takes a few points to get used to the difference of ends.
Started with so much verve, so much vigour in this match, Gilmour. She's had that throughout the entire year so far, the entire season, part of the Scotland side that cemented their place into the finals of the European Team Championships just a couple of weeks ago with a 4-1 win over the host, the Czech Republic, 10 days ago, in fact, also beating Latvia 5-0. Qualifying group winners will go with the host, Belgium, Holland, Scotland, France, Sweden, Spain, Ireland, and as well, last but not least, Poland. So plenty of decent countries that's going to be involved in that. And Scotland, well, they're not the favourites, but the form that their players are in right now, they could perhaps be in the shake-up at the end.
Yeah, they've got a great squad of players. They showed that in the Commonwealth Games. Really unlucky not to win a team medal. I think the draw was a bad draw for them. So they've got a great group at Scotstoun and really training hard, some great coaches, fantastic setup, and you're beginning to see the fruits of that.
Well, they really are beginning to bear their fruits of their labour here. A lot of funding has gone into the Scottish Badminton Association over the last few years. Of course, wonderful to be here inside the Emirates Arena. Good news for all badminton fans in this part of the world and Great Britain. Glad that it has been confirmed that the 2017 World Championships will take place here in this very arena. It's a real feather in the hat for Anne Smiley, the chief executive of Badminton Scotland and the Glasgow City Council, to host such a prestigious and big tournament in badminton. And after the success of this year's Commonwealth Games, it's a real boost for the city, the organisers, the tournament volunteers, and of course the supporters here. Kirsty Gilmour, just at 21 years of age, no doubt will be in the prime just 3 years from now. And she'll be here as well, providing that she is injury-free. That is a badly needed point for Gilmour. Sato just beginning to stretch her legs in the opening early exchanges here in game number two.
Hey, Gilmour really can't let Sato get a good lead. Gilmour is a great fighter. I've seen her come back from 6, 7, 8 points down incredibly. When I've been commentating on her and saying, oh, she can't come back from here, and then she does. But you don't really want to be in that position all the time. You want to just stay within, you know, sort of a hair's distance between you and your opponent. So you don't want to keep relying on that fighting spirit all the time.
Oh, what a rally. Beautifully done in the end. Oh, you said, Gail, she's a gutsy, determined fighter. A huge amount of skill as well.
And that was a professional shot she just hit there. She could have over-rotated, went gone for the line a little bit more, and that would have put that shuttle out into the tram lines. The side tram lines are out in badminton singles. But she didn't. She controlled that shot really well, and that was really good to see. Sato's net play has been really inconsistent in this match. We talk about left-handers. They're able to spin that shuttle somehow a little bit more. It's to do with the left wing of a feather on a goose that makes up the shuttles, and that spin that left-handers can create, it's just not working for her today.
It was clear what she was trying to do there, girl. Just drop the face of the racket. Well, again, deja vu. Can ill afford to give a quality player like Gilmour a cheap point, not once, but twice.
I don't know if she tried to correct her shot or... But this is where she could do with that coach.
Well, she's going to need to draw on a deep reservoir of belief here, Sato. She's got off to a good start. She's going to turn this around. She needs to get ahead and stay ahead. As it is Gilmour now. We're very much like yourself, Gail, all fantastic badminton players. You just find that extra gear, that extra level, just when you need it.
Yeah, hopefully it comes out. Sometimes we don't find it. But yeah, Kirsty is one of those who we know that she can really dig deep. And that's the key to being a successful athlete now. It's not just having all the skill and the physical fitness, it's being able to win when it matters.
Oh, did she break a string there, Gilmour? She's just checking the racket there. Caught in two minds, really.
It's that forehand corner again. Just hesitating on that drop shot. Taking a few moments to compose herself.
After working hard to get herself back on track, get herself ahead again, Gilmour. Right off Sato, at your peril, really. Oh, how good was that? Oh, this she hurt here, Gilmour.
Well, I did say that sometimes we need to pad her up with knee pads, elbow pads, or sometimes a crash helmet. And this is why she plays with her heart on her sleeve, but here she launches herself, and I'm not sure if she's holding her... She was holding her hip early on the floor, but...
Well, she's moving very gingerly just off the court right now. Doesn't look to be too sinister, the injury. Let's hope it is. Nothing too untoward.
Her coach isn't looking too impressed at her, is she? Just
well, she certainly isn't, Yvette. Good to see her back here alongside Gilmour once again. Of course, Chris Brewer took over for the Commonwealth Games while Yvette had a leave of absence, in fact. She is here back once again in Glasgow, and as you said, girl, not looking too impressed there.
I think it's a look of not impressed and then a bit of concern as well.
Well, you've got to be hard-pushed to get some emotion from her at the best of times. Certainly not there with that dive from Gilmour. It's a good effort, but all in vain.
But what I love about Kirsty is she brings that physicality on the court. There are not many girls that would go and dive. And ladies singles now is at that level where you have to push yourself, keep pushing yourself. So for anyone watching this game and thinking ladies singles is a nice, easy one, it's not anymore.
Well, right here, right now, it is anything but easy for Kirsty Gilmour. One game in the bank already, but 3 points adrift here in game number two. Oh!
Perfectly executed shot there.
That's what she needs to do, Gilmour. Get the crowd on side again. Energise the spectators here inside the Emirates Arena.
That's it. And shots like that will definitely do that. Oh, Oh, Sato hit that smash so
eight,
well.
Nine.
But she over-rotated as that left-handed shot round the shuttle, cross-court. There's just too much slice on it.
Did she get it? She's asking the question here, Gilmour.
10-8.
She thinks it's landed out. It wasn't a steep smash. It was going very flat. I have to look at the replay to see if the line judge got it right, but...
Well, she's shaking her head. She's yet to question the call. Now, that was very, very close indeed.
Oh, we can't quite get it. It floated. It didn't go down. The trajectory was wrong. It may have just shocked a few people. The umpire is allowed to overrule, but the umpire went along with the line judge. No Hawkeye in badminton here.
Well, there really is no margin for error in game number two. That point, in the end, could prove to be decisive. Aiming to get a game against Gilmour for the first time in this meeting number two out there, Sato. Be a huge boost if she were to achieve it. Well, it's close again, Gail.
Service over, 11-9, interval.
And Kirsty knows that was definitely in. That was bad judgment from her.
Well, she's perhaps going to get a short, sharp, quick endorsement in her ears here from her coach, Kirsty Gilmour. Indeed, she is. Not a good way to walk back to your coach on the back of that mistake.
No, it's not. And the vet will hopefully just pick out a couple of things that Kirsty really needs to focus on. For me, I think you were spot on, Errol, when you said about getting the crowd involved. She really needs that. She needs to draw off the energy of the crowd and the supporters here. And she's not quite managed to do that, partly due to the inconsistency of her play. That forehand corner, which is just hitting some weak drop shots in the net, is just not good enough. Sato isn't playing well at the net, so use that net, really drag her in, get those net shots going, and where Sato is struggling. And it's just, again, you know, sort of that composure that she needs. I know she's still young. It's that maturity on court, the composure, that professionalism to go on court and beat someone like Sato.
It's good to see Sato again injury-free and back perhaps to what will be her best. Of course, 2009 World Junior Championships runner-up. Been a member of the national team in Japan since 2010. Again, another badminton player who leaves everything on the court, as you said, Gail. And that's so refreshing, so good to see. Big point this time for Gilmour. She really needed that.
She needed that point because it was a long, stretched-out rally, both girls. Hitting the corners, retrieving the shots, fantastic. It would have hurt the legs. She came out on top, so she needs that. Needs to draw on the strength of winning these rallies.
Oh, again, a full stretch from Gilmour, all in vain.
Thank you so much. 12.
Sato, primarily an offensive player, Gail, up against someone with the quality of Gilmour. Attack, the best form of defence, or the other way round, perhaps?
I think it would be mixing them up for me and just sticking with it. I think Kirsty's weakness is that she can overcomplicate things. She does try out the crazy shot, the show-off shot. And when the simple ones are, you know, so if you play a simple game with Kirsty, that's what Sato's got to do. She's got to play the simple game and make Kirsty go for the shots, the outrageous stuff, and make the mistakes.
Well, again, she'll learn from that, Gilmour. She's only 21, as you said. Oh. She does collate and gather a vital experience. She'll learn exactly when to mix it up. 27, 28 years of age, perhaps, and you was at your peak, and that's your very best. She's still a long way from that.
Yeah, you're making me feel very old now, Errol. Thanks.
Well, I'm a lot older than you yourself, Miss M, so I'm no...
Lovely cross-court net shot from Kirsty. This is incredible. She placed that shuttle when the shuttle has gone past her body. She managed to get her racket and her arm out there, reached out and turned the shuttle at the same time. Fantastic shot.
Another beautifully constructed point from Gilmour. Patient for Sonny Fire, she bided her time and chose the right moment there to strike.
It's like she listened to us talking, I think, Errol, there. I think she listened to what I had to say. Get Sato in at the net, move her in, get those net shots going, cross her. It was fantastic. That last smash was perfectly timed. It wasn't too much, it wasn't trying too hard. It was perfect placement. That was really good professional lady singles play.
Well, I couldn't concur more with that fact anymore if I tried. They don't give out MBEs just to anybody these days, Gail. And perhaps if she continues to make progress, keep working hard, Kirsty Gilmour, perhaps you'll be there one day as well. Oh. I really had to adjust and change the shape of her body there.
She was so early for the forehand net shot. I thought she was going to come in and attack. She had all the time and she just tried to just... She, in the end, she got caught up in two minds. She just pushed the shuttle over the net that gave Sato that opportunity to come in and made able to put that shuttle over her head. And Gilmour was just caught out.
It really is too close to call, too... Close for comfort, really, in game number two here, Gail. 14 points to 13. Of course, this year, a big topic of debate, of course, the new scoring system, Gail, that was implemented this year. The 5-11 scoring system, in fact. The psychology and strategy, of course, will be different for playing 11 points. What are your viewpoints on that, your take on that?
I personally was not a fan of the best of 5 to 11. I think that you lose the fitness element of badminton if it's to 11 points. What I love about badminton is that you can play it if you're incredible, you're an endurance athlete or you're a speed and power athlete. And by taking out the endurance element, then you would just have very big, strong, powerful badminton players. And you're stereotyping already by the scoring system. With a 21 scoring system, you allow endurance athletes and power athletes to be able to compete at the same time. And that's, for me, is really important.
And it is May next year that the Badminton World Federation have agreed to invite a tournament host to trial this system. It was Brazil in August. It was the first Grand Prix tournament that it was implemented in. Of course, their view, their attitude was that the scoring system ensures that each point is even more important with limited time to bed yourself in. Bit of a lottery in some ways, Gail, and glad to be back to the old scoring system here this week in Glasgow.
Yeah, I am glad. In big arenas, you get used to different ends, and 11 points will just go. And the average time of the games was only about 20 minutes. Is that enough?
Well, not really, in my opinion. I think their viewpoint was, well, to give more excitement to the supporters and, you know, that raise the level of anticipation, the level of excitement, reducing the time which matches took to be completed. Well, of course, they will sit down in a room once again next year as to whether that 5-11 scoring system will be in place for Rio 2016, the next Olympic Games.
Well, that's a very long rally from the ladies singles match on court. that would have hurt the lungs, hurt the legs. Just walk, Kirsty Gilmour was just flicking sweat off just to give herself a little bit of extra time to get the breathing back, get that lactic out of her legs for the next point.
Well, the pendulum continues to swing back and forth in game number two. It really is there for the taking. Getting closer and closer here to the finishing line, and still one solitary point, the difference between these two players. It's intense and it is compelling viewing right now. Second rally again, Gail.
I think I was breathing hard just watching that. That hurts. That really, really hurts. The physicality of both these girls is incredible. They've asked the umpire to towel down because the way these girls were moving, if that shuttle had got over the net from the start to that cross-court drop shot, I mean, Gilmour was stretching. You can hear how heavy she's breathing. She's blowing her nose. Just trying to get as much oxygen into those lungs, because she knows that next rally could be exactly the same.
Well, we held our breath in here, the commentary booth, the crowd, approximately 1,000 to 1,500 supporters as well. They held their breath. And the reason for that as well, just have a look at the scoreboard, 17 points each. Everybody here fully engrossed in this wonderful second game. Where's it going to go? Well, Kirsty Gilmour doing her utmost best here to take it. Oh, that is another magnificent rally. At times, the shot production, Gail, was sublime.
The quality of that rally was incredible. And as the rally went on, you could hear the girls breathing, as usually you can just hear the shot, the racquet and the shuttle hitting against each other. But then you just suddenly heard the breathlessness because how much effort was going in. And Kirsty just trying to get a few more seconds. She's asked to change the shuttle, but Sato has said no. They're back into it. They've got the umpire needs to hurry them up. There's no rest like there are in tennis or any other sports. You have to carry on. Play should be continuous, but I would not like it to be continuous right now if I was on that court.
Oh, the margins so tight, 18 all.
That was a clever tactic from Kirsty Gilmour. She slowed that shuttle right down. She did a clear, a punch clear, disguise clear. Sato expected a drop shot. She was running in towards the net and suddenly got stuck in position. Very clever.
Certainly taking her time here with this next serve, Gilmour. As you said, Gail, just buying an extra precious few seconds. Well left, and there was a very determined clenched fist there from the number one seed, Kirsty Gilmour, 19-18.
She was very lucky there. That was a poor cross-court lift. Sato was there, ready to attack. And that was an unforced error from Sato. She should have killed that onto the floor. Went very flat.
Inches at full stretch, diving to get the shuttlecock over the net, and again for the third time, all in vain. Well, perhaps she's hurt herself again. Grazed knees, grazed elbows. Perhaps the physios are going to make an appearance if this continues here for Kirsty Gilmour.
She landed straight on her elbow. The good news is that she gets a bit more time because the mopper is out to clear up the sweat, but she launches herself. Her head, her heart, her racket is going for that shuttle. It's just her body can't quite keep up at the end of that rally. And
oh, this really is marvellous to see. It's so intense. We're stood up, Gail, but the supporters here on the edge of their seats, really. It's a wonderful arena, a cost of £113 million. In fact, in my mind, it is money very well spent indeed. Just cannot wait to be back here to witness the 2017 World Badminton Championships. But right here, right now, it is the Scottish Grand Prix on our minds, and it is 19 points apiece, this time with Sato on serve.
Sato has hit that in the net. She hit it way too flat. She caught the top of the tape with that net. She was going for that cross court into Kirsty Gilmour's backhand. And she has just given Kirsty Gilmour a match point.
Well, what a time to find the net there for the unseeded Japanese player. After a very tense, topsy-nervy second game, the number one seed again, Kirsty Gilmour for a chance in the final. Saved, and how brave was she there? That is incredible badminton.
She was really brave. Both girls didn't want to give an inch, and Kirsty Gilmour, she just rushed that defensive shot. She was lucky to get the good blocks in. She thought she had Sato out of position. Sato got back in, hit that smash. Kirsty Gilmour swung her racket too early. She knew where she had to hit that shot, but just caught that frame and ended up at the bottom of the net.
Well, she was on the ropes in that rally, Sato. She dug deep, and in the end, rewarded again for her bravery. What a turnaround. And having saved a match point, she has a chance here to take this match into another game. Dropped out. Okay. It is a fantastic reaction and a fantastic renaissance here from Sato, the unseeded Japanese player. The first time meeting number two between the two players, Sato has taken a game from Kirsty Gilmour. It is one game all. She takes it 22 points to 20, Gail, and that was such a close second game.
It was a painful game as well. It was so brutally physical. I think that this will be interesting. Who is going to have that energy in the third? Because both girls were covering every single centimetre of that court. We saw Kirsty Gilmour diving around because her legs were couldn't quite keep up with the rally. It's just so intense. And Kirsty Gilmour had her chance there. She had her chance to win that second game, and she, in my eyes, she blew it. These are the learning points of which we've been talking about, that how she has to go on there and win these games in two straight sets to conserve that energy. Sato, she took her time.
Well, this is where having a wonderful coach in your corner perhaps can play great dividends, because she needs to eradicate that match point from her mind now. Get down to business, dust herself down and start all over again. Interesting to see whether she can do exactly that, Kirsty Gilmour. This is where all the practice, all the fitness regime, that's where it comes to the table, Gail. This is a real match of attrition. It's almost like a war out there right now.
It is, yeah, that is it. It is who is going to be the last person on that court who will physically not let their opponent hit that shuttle on that ground. And it is a battle, it is a war. And we would talk about the scoring system. You know, this is what I love to see. Who has got the mental and physical strength in a third game with a match this quality? If it was better 5-11, we wouldn't see this.
Final game. Le
four, play. Well, plenty more of what we witnessed in game number two, please, ladies. Sato here with the first serve. Well, she's making her debut here this year at the Scottish Open, Sato. What a debut it's been. All the way through to the semi-final here this afternoon. And still in good shape, perhaps. To go one stage further.
Too long.
Looks to the heavens, Sato.
Serve it over. One, two.
To drop that over the net again, just overcooking it.
Well, Kirsty Gilmour in that rally, she jumped up. She was trying to get that physical strength going, get her legs moving, jumping up for a punch clear, coming in nice and early to get the net. But unfortunately, she just pushed that wide. You can see she's trying to keep her legs moving.
She really went for that.
There's the overcompensation again when you're tired. This is where she needs to learn to control her emotions and her tiredness. Body language of the two players is incredibly different as well. Sato, she's ready to serve. She's in position, whereas Kirsty is just taking her time. When you see your opponent walking around the court slowly, you know you've got that one up against them. You know that you're fitter. Such a boost.
Well, she's completely battle hardened so far this week, Gail, in three game matches against the Swede earlier on. Dropped the first. 16-21, turn it around, 21-9, 21-14, 2 minutes shy of 1 hour to get the job done. Well, she needs a glut of points here, albeit we're still at the early stages of this game. It's a good lead here for Sato, 4 points. Mix things up, Gail, but so far the Japanese has had a lot of answers to everything Gilmour's thrown at her since the first game. She can be such a deceptive player at times, Gilmour, just when she looks down and out, ambling around the court. Somewhere, somehow, she just finds that level of fitness again, gets the intensity back in her game.
Maybe it's a tactic to act like you're really, really tired and then just jump up and say, no, I'm not.
Well, she's certainly keeping everybody here fully engrossed in this battle. Well, how about that? Beautifully done again.
The flexibility and agility from Sato to play this shot. She's taking the shuttle behind her to the side of her body. She gets her left leg into that extreme lunge position, gets her racket onto the shuttle, and then is able to have the control to hit that shuttle cross court past Gilmour. You begin to feel that it's taking, those sort of shots are taking its toll on Kirsty Gilmour. If your opponent's coming out with shots like that, with agility and flexibility in the third set, you know you're in for a very long, hard battle.
Well, this is where it really is a battle of wills, a battle of mental strength as well as fitness. Oh, she did well to get there. She's lost out, taking a couple of points at full stretch. Just about got that one.
Well, this is unlucky for Sato because this shot should have been at the back of the court, but somehow hit the top of the tape. Spun so many times, it just ended up going straight back down. And unfortunately for Sato, on her side of the net.
Well, again, the buffer has gone back to 5 points here for Sato. Touched upon the fact earlier on in this match, Gail, that she's going to re-emerge on this very court again in the doubles with Imogen Bankier. This is a tough ask so far here for Kirsty Gilmour.
It is really tough, and she will have that in the back of her mind. I know she's supposed to focus completely on her singles, but you can't help wondering, she'll be thinking maybe I should save some energy for the doubles.
So much expectancy on her shoulders here, of course, being in her home competition, on home soil. The Scottish Badminton in such a good place right now, have a high level of investment, moving forward to develop all of the talent and memberships and clubs in schools, and really is increasing every year. And as you said, we're seeing them bear the fruits of their labour right now, and this lady is such an integral part of that. At full stretch this time, fortunately for Gilmour, crashing into the post there, and she is hurt. Oh.
Just taking a few moments. I'm not sure where, what she's hurt, but she threw herself at that.
Oh. Felt the pain almost up here. That is not what we want to see. And again, it's Sato, that ability just to drop it over the net. Just look how much court she had to cover to get that. Incredible. Let's hope that she's okay and she can continue on the fight here, Kirsty Gilmour.
Well, the tournament referee is here and the physio. She's pointing to her neck at the moment. Must have landed awkwardly. It's not like you're diving for... She's got a racquet in her hand, so you're diving as well as trying to hit a shuttle, so you're never completely in control of the dive. You've got your arm out. You're trying to... Your other arm will be trying to support yourself so you don't hurt anything, but when your mind is going for that shuttle, your body will just go with whatever's happening, and it's not a controlled dive. And I love the fact that she dives on court. I love it. The guys dive, but they get back up really quickly. It's a control dive. This is where she needs to learn maybe to say no. I can't get that shot. And if she keeps injuring herself this way, it's not good, because this could affect her doubles, affect the rest of this match. I'm not sure where the line is, but sometimes she does go over that line.
Well, there is a steely hush that has descended around the Emirates Arena here in Glasgow. And fingers crossed that she is fit to fight. Continue on the battle here, Kirsty Gilmour. Yet to complete 200 matches in her singles career. You touched upon the fact, quite rightly, Gail, she needs to learn when to go for it, when not to. But I suppose the magnitude of the situation here in Glasgow, perhaps just getting the better of her, really.
I know, and I would never want to take that away from someone. I really don't. I've talked about Kirsty, how inspirational she is. She's such a role model for young people and for ladies singles in Europe. She really is. I just have to wrap her up in cotton wool at the same time.
Oh, she's back on her feet. Still 4 points adrift here, Gilmour. Well, all to do here for Gilmour. Breathe life in her campaign right now, Gail. She's fallen down on four occasions, in fact. Correct me if I'm wrong, it could be three. She's bounced back and got up on every occasion, but she's human after all. She isn't made of steel. How much more of this punishment can she take? In this magnitude, well.
I'm trying to listen into what Yvette Ulan's trying to tell her. Talking about changing of the pace of the rallies.
Well, both players have earned themselves a very well earned drink. Here alone, no coach, thousands of miles away from Japan. But so far, she really has risen to the challenge, Sato. It's incredible to watch.
She has, and I'm guessing, you know, all the things that she's learned from coming back from that ankle injury, that mental toughness, she's putting those things into practice in her badminton play. She is here on her own, and she's fighting and working things out for herself. Sato is just stuck in there. She's been patient.
Gilmour perhaps still feeling effects on that last ball. Sato again, not for the first time, has herself a healthy lead in game number three.
They've been playing for over an hour now. These girls, 61 minutes is up on the board. And Kirsty Gilmour just looking very tired as she left that shot, hoping it was, wishing it was out.
Well, she certainly wished that last shot was out, and she got her wish in the end. That was a very badly needed point indeed. Well, if she were to lose this match, Gail, this is where her coach really does need to get to work when she'll be back here in the women's doubles. Sit her down. Perhaps a touch of sticky tape or plaster see needed. And they're back in the action again.
Yeah, I used to play ladies' doubles and mixed doubles, and sometimes I'd have one match. A mixed doubles first, and then a few matches later, I'll be on for ladies' doubles. So, yeah, you're absolutely right. You have to just, whether you have to get your head right, whether you've just lost that first game, and then you have to get your head into a positive frame of mind to play the next match, you have to completely change your tactics, your mentality, because you're going from two different disciplines. Then you have to refuel, rehydrate. There is a lot to think about just to get on that court. And for Kirsty, if she's got a slight injury as well, then there's got extra medical issues to sort out as well.
Well, it is 15 points to 9 now. And Sato is the player who has one foot in the door, perhaps, to the final.
It's over.
Good placement from Sato. Perfect shot. Right down the line. Good speed on the shuttle as well.
Well, it's so good to see, and it's the sign of a good player. To re-emerge once again from her injury woes.
Eight. Service over.
Well, tired she may be, Gilmour, but she watched that to perfection.
And Sato looking at the umpire, maybe for an overall, but the umpire's going with the line judge.
Point. She really did, Gilmour. A lot of heart and a lot of courage in that point.
There's a change of pace as well. The rally started off nice and high clears, and then Kirsty Gilmour injected that pace. She came in for that net kill. She put some extra pace. She cut that shuttle down. It's whether she can keep that momentum going. Can she bring this back?
Times in game number two, the level of badminton really was of the highest order. It's much more of a four-tenths affair now, Gail, and still Sato, who's asking the questions here of Gilmour.
Has gone out, and I hate to say this, but it was a tired shot. You could see that Kirsty was drained. It was a slow movement to that backhand front corner. Again, another tired movement.
Well, oh, let's see here. Really does need to find a late charge somewhere here, Gilmour, because Sato, against all odds, dropping the first game, is on the cusp, on the verge here. It would be another excellent game to take. If it is going to happen, Gail, it starts right here, right now.
It has to. She's running out of time. She's running out of opportunities.
You've been in this situation many times before. You really have had to dig deep, draw on your reserves. That's what she needs to do. I mean, throw everything in, perhaps, that she has in her locker.
That's gone out. This is it. It's match point to Sato now.
Well, what a chance. What a situation here for Sato. Sayaka Sato, the unseeded player of Japan, after dropping the first game, has herself match point here. Well, what a way to do it. The first time of asking on her first match point. After dropping the first game, the unseeded Japanese player here, Sayaka Sato, has defeated the number one seed here in the women's singles, and she will be back here on this court tomorrow in the final and give herself a good chance here of being crowned champion in Glasgow. 16-21, 22-20, and then in some style in game number three, 21-12, job done. Sato is in the final here tomorrow. How fitting. It ends on another shot that she just dropped in there from the Japanese player. In the end, perhaps fatigue and tiredness just got the better of Kirsty Gilmour, but a lot of credit where credit is due to Sato. She's a worthy winner here in Glasgow. We very much look forward to seeing her once again here in the final tomorrow. How sporting it is from the crowd that they warmly applaud off two fantastic players here. It was a wonderful match. Just a touch over an hour, and in the end, we've got a lot of money's worth there from both players. Good to see. And it is Sato, unfortunately, here for the sponsors, the organisers and the crowd. Kirsty Gilmour has fallen here in the semi-finals.